Wham! As the diamond stud takes the partner D-man in the corner. Up and down goes the D-man at the hand of the only stud, the diamond stud, and Diamond Dallas Page. And the diamond stud seem to be ripping the D-man to shreds.
Everyone, and welcome to World Championship Wrestling here on TBS. We are coming to you from the Coliseum in Macon, Georgia. Jim Ross and Paul E. Dangerously at ringside, and we have a tremendous two-hour broadcast. We are expecting a major announcement within the broadcast from Executive Vice President of WCW, Mr. Jim Herd.
You know, I heard about this in the locker room. I have no idea what it's about, so why don't you, Mr. Scoop, tell me what's going on?
I have no idea other than it is a major announcement. We will have it in this broadcast, but also in the broadcast, we will see the new WCW television champion, Stunning Steve Austin.
Stunning Steve Austin, who at the Great American Bash has to wrestle 20 feet above the ring on a scaffold.
Plus, ladies and gentlemen, the United States heavyweight champion and number one contender for the world's championship, Lex Luger, will be on this broadcast as well.
Lex Luger just 8 days away from perhaps realizing his destiny to become the heavyweight champion of the world.
Plus, returning to TBS, we will see Robert Gibson, and he will join forces with Dustin Rhodes in tag team competition.
As the old expression goes, and as Richard Morton told me, money walks and Gibson walks, huh?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be a phenomenal broadcast. Our curiosity really is aroused about that major announcement from Jim Herd, Executive Vice President of WCW. But right now, let's go up to Gary Michael Capetta and our first event on TBS.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest on World Championship Wrestling. It is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Venice Beach, California, weighing 251 pounds, this is Steve. His opponent from Macon, Georgia, 238 pounds, Pete Steinborn.
What an ovation for the singer here on TBS. Keith Steinborn will be the opponent. And of course, the singer deeply involved in one of the most physically intense feuds in WCW with Nikita Koloff. And his singer starting out on the offense very quickly with a side headlock.
Well, what do you think it is?
The announcement from Jim Herd, I have no idea other than it is major news, I understand.
Well, you don't think he's going to fire me from this show, do you? I mean, I apologize about beating up Jason Hervey.
I don't think it has anything to do with you as Sting holds on to the side headlock.
Oh!
And you can hear Keith Steinborn's reaction from the tremendous power exerted by the singer. Nice shoulder block by the youngster from Venice Beach, California. The man that has captured the hearts and imaginations of the little singers around the country. Great drop kick.
Oh yeah, everything he does in wrestling is great. He's probably one of the greatest stars in all of sports today, but 8 days from now at the Great American Bash, the singer is out of his element because he takes on Nikita Koloff in a Russian chain match.
Steinborn trying to gain an advantage, like running into a brick wall there. We'll also have our latest WCW Top 10 here in the program. And as we said, Jim Herd is conferring right now with the WCW members. Many of the board of directors are here. Mr. Herd is in the arena, so we will hear from him a little bit later in the broadcast.
You know, if Sting would just stand there when Nikita Koloff comes running at him during a Russian chain match, he might get his head sickled off.
Well, in all due respect, Nikita Koloff is in an entirely different level than Keith Steinborn. And I'm sure the fans tonight in Norfolk, Virginia, will be enjoying the Great American Bash on tour tonight in Norfolk. Starts at 8 o'clock.
Singer's doing a real smart thing here. He's using his height. He's using his power to his advantage. Now Steinborn showing his power by pulling the hair because, hey, the singer has a lot of hair.
Einborn with some very ineffective right hands. And that's the look of intensity. The man that represents all the small fans that paint their faces on a nightly basis at these WCW events. And we know there'll be a lot of them. There's a young one right there holding a sign up.
And here it comes.
There's the Irish Whip and a Seeger Splash. Bringing the U's and R's from the thousands that are on hand here at the Coliseum in Macon, Georgia. And now the Scorpion Deathlock, a submission move. And not even Nikita Koloff can tolerate that.
Ladies and gentlemen, here goes the winner, Sting!
We will take another look at the closing moments of this contest. That man on a collision course with Nikita Koloff.
Tonight at the Scope in Norfolk, Virginia, the Stinger bringing the Great American Bash into town. The Stinger splash into the corner. Keith Steinborn goes down right into the Scorpion Deathlock. Keith Steinborn saying the only two words that he knows in his situation, I quit.
Fans will have more action, but first, here's this week's WCW Top 10.
And now, fans, here's a look at World Championship Wrestling's Top 10 as compiled by promoters and members of the WCW Board of Directors. In the number 10 slot, from Macon, Georgia, he's a bad man, Johnny B. Bad. Preceded by, in the number 9 slot, the All-American from Warner Robins, Georgia, Ron Simmons. The number 8 man this week, the Diamond Stud out of Tampa, Florida. Followed by 7'7" Elegante, of course, from Argentina. The former World TV Champion, Arn Anderson, 258 pounds from Minnesota, the number 6 spot. Followed by number 5, beautiful Bobby from Huntsville, Alabama. The World Television Champion, stunning Steve Austin, checks in at number 4, of course. He's from Hollywood, California. The Stinger, the former world champion, is at number 3 this week. The number 2 man, Barry Windham out of Sweetwater, Texas. And the number 1 contender, the current U.S. champion, Lex Luger. And, of course, the world champion from Charlotte, Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
To TBS and World Championship Wrestling. Before we return to the ring, let's hear these comments from the Z-Man.
The Diamond Stud. Next Sunday, finally, it's going to come down to the Z-Man and the Big Diamond Stud. You know, a couple weeks back, you ripped my clothes off on TV. Real impressive. You had to hit me from the blind side, didn't you, Stud? And you, Dallas Page, were the instigator. So it's all coming down to next week. I'm going to get my revenge. Believe me, I am. Because Diamond Dallas Page, you stuck your man on me. I'm not only going to beat him up, but I'm coming after you, Page.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing team number 1 from the Heartliners Collection Agency, Dirty Dick Slater, Dick Murdoch, the Hardliners. And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, total combined weight, 478 pounds, from Baltimore, Maryland, Jumpin' Joey Mag, Dave Johnson.
Interesting comments from the Z-Man regarding the Diamond Stud, and quite an embarrassing situation. The Diamond Stud put the Z-Man in recently on this broadcast, but we are here now ready for tag team action and a team, Slater and Murdoch, known as the Hardliners, two of the toughest men that I've ever been around in my 20 years in professional wrestling. That man, Dick Slater, his partner, Dick Murdoch, they have done what many thought was impossible. They have injured the Steiners to the point that Scott Steiner will be out of action for perhaps 2 or 3 more months.
Well, I figured out why Jim Hurd is here this evening.
What is your assumption?
He's here to announce that the Steiner brothers have taken all that they can take, that they've given up the belts, that they've given up everything. He's here to announce that the Hardliners are now the new World Tag Team Champions.
I don't think that his announcement, I know, has nothing to do with a tag team situation.
Oh.
So you're wrong again. Sorry. Overhand wrist lock by Dick Slater quickly tags in Dick Murdoch. This is a real veteran team. These guys have both been campaigning for over 20 seasons in professional wrestling, and two of the toughest guys in WCW. And again, I think you did bring up one point, believe it or not, Paul, that was somewhat valid.
Oh, really?
WCW must make some type of action, I would say, in the next week, perhaps 2 weeks, regarding the World Tag Team title situation.
Oh, yeah, we're closing in on the 30 days, and of course what that means is that if you're a champion in World Championship Wrestling, you must defend the title within a 30-day period, and that 30-day period is almost up for Rick and Scott Steiner.
Well, I do know that Rick Steiner will be fulfilling all the tag team obligations that he and his brother signed, and word tells me that he may be having a mystery partner, and he will be having a mystery partner for that matter in some of the events during the Great American Bash.
Well, what's a mystery to me is why Rick Steiner would even want to mess with the Hardliners anymore. I mean, they've already beaten up Rick Steiner, and they put Scott Steiner out of action. I mean, all these fans that are so into the Steiner brothers right now can't see their heroes anymore because of these two.
Murdoch dominating Dave Johnson out here on the outside. So fans, if you're planning on being with us tonight in Norfolk or perhaps tomorrow night in Richmond, Virginia, Rick Steiner will be fulfilling all he and his brother's tag team obligations, and he has let us know that he will be bringing a mystery partner to those matches with the Hardliners. So it's going to be interesting to see just exactly who will be joining forces with the Dogface Gremlin in these matches. Whomever it may be, that person better be prepared for a very physical and a very intense battle.
See, Murdoch's in there trying to make this kid suffer. He wants to teach him a lesson. He wants everybody out there to know that they realize that they're at the apex of their career, that they can't out-wrestle the Steiners, but they can out-fight them, and that's what's going to bring them to the World Tag Team Championship.
Slater and Murdoch not only have their sights set on ending the careers of both Steiners, they have their sights set obviously on Rick Steiner at the current time, but they also want to be the World Tag Team Champions. Slater working on the arm, bringing Johnson outside. Got that arm hammered locked behind him and takes him into the steel post. Here right beside us, we have seen the Hardliners on many occasions in the last several weeks demolish each and every opponent they have been in the ring with, and most of them have been beaten by submission. And here's Murdoch with Johnson on his shoulder. And Murdoch moved the whole ring using Johnson's shoulder like a battering ram right into the post.
You know, I've seen a lot of people that like to hurt other wrestlers, but I've never seen a duo that actually enjoy ending careers like Murdoch and Slater. When they say they're the Hardline Collection Agency, they're not just collecting money and belts, they're collecting careers.
The veteran team focusing on the arm of Dave Johnson, again ramming his shoulder and upper arm into the turnbuckle. A lot of big things happening in WCW. The WCW magazine will be on the newsstands nationwide on August the 6th. We're excited about that.
Oh man, Slater's gonna break that arm clean off. Look at the pressure he's applying right there.
Checking the arm tremendously against the grain. And Slater makes the exchange now with Dick Murdoch. Both these men have been very decorated veterans of in-ring competition. They have held many championships over their illustrious careers. But one thing that has eluded them as a unit is the WCW World Tag Team Championship. Got that arm bar, Murdoch with a wide base. They know all the pressure points. They know exactly how to exert their leverage. They don't mind getting battered and bruised themselves in the process.
Oh no, they're not pretty boys. They don't come out here saying, hey, don't punch my teeth down my throat. They don't care what kind of sacrifices they have to make as long as they get the job done. Job number one was to eliminate the Steiner brothers, and it looks to me like we may never see Rick and Scott together again.
Fans, if you just tuned in, we said at the top of the broadcast that we would be hearing from Executive Vice President of World Championship Wrestling, Mr. Jim Hurd, who is here in the arena. He is in the media room, I understand, meeting with many of the members of the board of directors, and a major announcement concerning all of us here at WCW is forthcoming in the program here on TBS.
You think he's here to give me a raise and a bonus for the fine job I've been doing out here?
Tremendous right hand by Murdoch. Paul, everything that happens here doesn't surround you, okay? He's not here to talk about you or Missy Hyatt or anyone. It's a major announcement. Murdoch again trying to dislocate the shoulder, and Johnson has had enough.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners. 30 Dick Slater, Dick Murdoch, the Hardliners.
Murdoch and Slater looking forward to their next meeting with Rick Steiner and a mystery partner wherever it may be on the Great American Bash Tour. And they have yet another victory here on WCW, again by submission. Two of the toughest veterans to ever step inside the squared circle. And as you see here, they had the one body part focused. It was the shoulder of Dave Johnson. And there you see Murdoch putting the finishing touches on the submission. Fans, now let's go to Paul E. Dangerously and this week's Great American Bash Control Center.
And the Great American Bash Control Center next Sunday night, July 14th at 7 p.m. Eastern Time, only on pay-per-view, the Great American Bash. There's only one way to see the legend versus the legacy, Ric Flair versus Lex Luger in a steel cage, is by picking up your telephone and telling your local cable operator, I want the Great American Bash. Now, in addition to all the main events that have been signed for the Bash, four more matches have been added this week. And a six-man elimination tag team match, the Fabulous Freebirds and Bad Street, will oppose the Natural Dustin Rhodes and the Young Pistols. In a bounty match for the mask, the Yellow Dog will take on Johnny B. Bad, Skywalker 2, 20 feet high on a scaffold, Beautiful Bobby and PN News against Terrence Taylor and Stunning Steve, and the Z-Man will take on the Diamond Stud. Here's why the Z-Man has demanded this particular encounter.
You dress more like a dud. It looks like the blue light special at Kmart was on constant rotation, brother. Get a clue, you can't be with.
Whoa! And the Diamond Stud just leveled the Z-Man. I guess we're going to find out who's just a stud and who is the stud.
After being embarrassed, after being humiliated by the Diamond Stud, the Z-Man has sworn revenge. And he says that revenge is going to take place next Sunday, July 14th at the Great American Bash. Both the Z-Man and the Diamond Stud are standing by right now with their comments regarding their big match next Sunday, July 14th, from the Baltimore Arena at the Great American Bash.
You know, Z-Man, we've already sifted your clothes, and at the Great American Bash next weekend, 6'7", 298 pounds of twisted steel and sex appeal is going to drop you like a bad habit.
Big Diamond Stud, you know, time's running out. Next weekend, July 14th, the Great American Bash. It's my chance for the Z-Man to get his revenge. You ripped my clothes off on national TV. Did you really think I was going to let you get away with it? No.
The Z-Man and the Diamond Stud will duke it out next Sunday, July 14th, exclusively on pay-per-view as part of the Great American Bash. Besides the legend versus the legacy, Nature Boy Ric Flair against Lex Luger in a cage, other matches signed include Missy Hyatt and the Steiner Brothers in a steel cage match against Arn Anderson, Barry Windham, and Paul E. Dangerously in a Russian chain match, Sting against the Russian Nightmare Nikita Koloff, Elegante in a battle of the Giants against the One Man Gang, the Skywalkers Part 2 on a scaffold, Beautiful Bobby and PN News against Stunning Steve and Terrence Taylor, bounty match for the mask, Johnny B. Bad against the Yellow Dog in a six-man tag team elimination match, the Natural Dustin Rhodes and the Young Pistols will oppose the Fabulous Freebirds and Bad Street, and the Z-Man will take on the Diamond Stud. There's only one way to see this card. Pick up your telephone, call your local cable operator, and tell them that you want the Great American Bash.
Memorial Auditorium in Greenville, South Carolina. Saturday night, July 13th, 8 o'clock bell time. Johnny B. Bad will be at the Citadel in Charleston, South Carolina this Friday night, July 12th. as a part of the Great American Bash. The Carolina Coliseum is the place to be in Columbia, South Carolina, to check out Black Flood and all the other WCW superstars this Thursday, July 11th. This Tuesday, July 9th, PN News will be rapping. You'll want to be clapping at the Civic Center in Tallahassee, Florida. The Bash will also make a tour stop at the Municipal Auditorium in Columbus, GA. This Monday night, July 8th, 7 o'clock bell time. The Coliseum in Richmond, Virginia is the place to be tomorrow night to check out 50 High and another WCW superstars. And tonight, you'll want to be at the Scope in Norfolk, Virginia. On a night full of World Championship Wrestling.
Tonight on TBS.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by Lady Blossom from Hollywood, California. Weighing 253 pounds, he is the WCW World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin. His opponent from Birmingham, Alabama, 241 pounds, Johnny Rich.
Popular young Johnny Rich to challenge the World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin. I want to remind all the kids that we're going to be hearing from a couple of interesting gentlemen. WCW Patriots have a special message I think all you kids are going to be to benefit from a little bit later in the broadcast, as Sonny Steve starts out very quickly on Johnny Rich with a straight right hand, the television champion, who in 8 days will join forces with Terrence Taylor to take on PN News and Beautiful Bobby in a scaffold match. Great American Bash pay-per-view. Good arm drag takeover by Johnny Rich, who, if he has one distinct advantage in the contest, and I think he does, that is his quickness.
Oh, yeah, Johnny Rich is a top contender, and here you have to admit that Stunning Steve is a fighting champion. He's not just resting on his laurels. He's out here fighting, and he's fighting a very tough customer in Johnny Rich.
Indeed, Beautiful Bobby Eaton has his side set on Stunning Steve in a rematch for the television championship. There's a nice leapfrog there, crossbody press. Johnny Rich going for the upset here in this non-title event. He got two out of it, came right back with an arm drag takeover, taking his bigger opponent off his feet. You have heard us here so many times talk about leverage and strategy. Johnny Rich does not have a strength advantage here, so he must use his quickness and speed to negate the strength advantage of Austin, and he does that by taking him to the canvas. Austin with a kick to the abdomen and one to the head.
And notice how Stunning Steve takes his time. He does one thing at a time, and he does it very, very well.
Side gut wrench suplex by Stunning Steve Austin, who will be a part of the Great American Bash this Monday night in Columbus, Georgia, the biggest card ever in Columbus, at the Municipal Auditorium, and another high-impact move by the television champ. On top for the press, but he picked Johnny Rich up before the referee could count three.
And here he goes with yet another suplex.
Standing vertical suplex by a man I think we could term very safely as arrogant. Another lateral press, and again he chooses not to pin his opponent.
Well, he's trying to send the message up, because not only is he part of the big, great American Bash in Columbus, but tomorrow night at the Richmond Coliseum, beautiful elbow drop by the TV champion. He's going to defend his title in Richmond, Virginia tomorrow night. And he's going to have her with him.
Of course. I don't think he goes anywhere without her.
Would you?
High side slam by Stunning Steve.
I mean, if you had an ultra fox like that following you around, wouldn't you take her everywhere you'd go?
I'm reserving my comments for Lady Blossom, I can assure you that. I think she's misnamed. And there she's again raking the eyes of Johnny Rich.
I don't think she was raking his eyes. I think Johnny Rich was lunging out and making a pass at her, and she knocked him back. And rightfully so.
I don't think anybody's going to agree with that. Stunning Steve dominating Johnny Rich at this point in time in the contest. Up and over, Johnny trying for a sunset flip, but Austin is just too strong. Still to come, the United States heavyweight champion. And the man that will wrestle for the world title at the Great American Bash on July 14th, Lex Luger, will be here. We'll be seeing Dustin Rhodes and Robert Gibson together for the first time here on TBS in the broadcast as well. Plus that announcement from Executive Vice President of WCW, Jim Herd, still to come. I understand Mr. Herd is preparing for that announcement. It could come at any time. We'll be taking you there live as soon as we are informed that he is ready.
Good game plan here by the world television champion. He's cutting off Johnny Rich's breathing. Rich has tremendous cardiovascular conditioning. He doesn't want Johnny up in the air and flying around, so he tries to immobilize him.
Well, Stunning Steve, I don't think has ever been in a scaffold match before with a lateral press, and this time Johnny Rich does kick out. I've seen a few of them, and they are so dangerous because the match fans will be competed on a scaffold that will cover the ring, 20 feet above the ring to be exact. Stunning Steve drops it all on Johnny Rich, and the only way you can see the scaffold match is by calling your local cable company and ordering the Great American Bash. It is a pay-per-view exclusive.
And Stunning Steve's game plan has really showed right now. It shows you what a great champion he is, because I've seen Johnny Rich wrestle 30, 35, 40 minutes in one match, and here now he's tired already. He's worn down. Stunning Steve has taken his breath away, and now Johnny Rich is at the mercy of Stunning Steve Austin.
Austin with a reverse chin lock, using his left knee for a leverage point. Very strong man, as Lady Blossom looks approvingly on. She was very instrumental in Austin winning the television championship from Beautiful Bobby.
Sure, Beautiful Bobby couldn't stop staring at her. He lost his whole game plan, and Stunning Steve beat him right in the center of the ring for the world TV title.
Did you see the same match I saw? Can you ever tell the truth?
Yeah.
Well, why don't you try it sometime? Austin, that's now a big arm around the neck of Johnny Rich. As we said, Rich comes with us with tremendous credentials. And many fans I know have followed his career. He's a cousin of the former world champion Tommy Wildfire Rich. Trying to come back up to a vertical base to relieve a little bit of the pressure. And Austin quickly takes him back into the corner. Austin, huge thighs. He's a really a strong man. Great agility as well. But this time, the quickness of Johnny Rich coming to the front. He's rolled him up and got two out of it. Austin rammed that ring post with his shoulder.
And Stunning Steve is in big trouble here.
And as Lady Blossom distracted Johnny Rich for just a moment, Stunning Steve took advantage of the situation. And there's a stun gun. The television champion with a vicious stun gun, and now ramming Rich's head to the canvas. The TV champ has won.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the WCW World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin.
We'll be taking another look at it and let you hear from the WCW Patriot.
Here you see a Stunning Steve, more stunning than Bobby is Beautiful, with a stun gun on Johnny Rich. Johnny finished right here, but just for good measure, he rammed Rich's head right into the canvas. The best wrestler on television today, the world TV champion, Stunning Steve Austin.
United States Heavyweight Champion Lex Luger is coming up next, but first, listen to this.
Hi, kids. I'm Todd Champion. This is Chip the Firebreaker. We're the WCW Patriots, and Chip's got a special fire safety tip for you guys, so listen up.
Hi, kids. My fire safety tip for this week is don't play with matches. I know you've heard it 100 times, but your mom and dad were right. Don't play with matches, or you'll get burned.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Chicago, Illinois, weighing 292 pounds, the WCW United States Heavyweight Champion, the Total Package, Lex Luger. His opponent from Amarillo, Texas, 262 pounds, Jeff Stone.
Another tremendous ovation here, ladies and gentlemen, for the United States Heavyweight Champion, the Total Package, Lex Luger. He is the number one contender. for the WCW World Heavyweight Championship. And in 8 days, he has the opportunity to realize a lifelong dream, that is to hold the richest prize in all of WCW, and that's the heavyweight championship.
Which proves, of course, that he's the greediest man in world championship wrestling.
What do you mean by that?
Well, he's the United States heavyweight champion. A belt that, whoa! A belt that has tremendous heritage. Johnny Valentine, Dusty Rhodes, Magnum T.A., the Russian Nightmare Nikita Koloff, Wahoo McDaniel. All of these legends have held the U.S. Heavyweight Championship. Luger now, once again the champion. Instead of carrying on the honor of the belt, he wants to be the world's champion.
Luger the side headlock taking Jeff Stone down. I think it's the goal of every athlete in WCW is to be the WCW World Heavyweight Champion. That's what they're all gunning for. And he would gladly give up the United States title to be the world's heavyweight champion. Jeff Stone with a thumb or finger in the eye. And now, no small man hammering Luger from behind. Well, Luger looks simply awesome.
Oh, what a clothesline!
Whoa! He just knocked Stone goofy.
Luger has him up! And he really planted him with that power slam. That's the move he defeated the great Muta with on July 12th. Now he's got big Jeff Stone up in the rack. And no one can withstand the punishment from that move.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the total package, Lex Luger!
8 days away. And obviously, Luger is in magnificent condition.
1 week and 1 day away from the biggest night of his life. Can the total package fulfill his destiny? Can he become the WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World? We'll find out next Sunday at the Great American Bash.
Fans, when we come back, Dustin Rhodes and Robert Gibson, tag team action.
In the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing team number one from Austin, Texas. He weighs 261 pounds. The Natural, Dustin Rhodes. His tag team partner from Pensacola, Florida, 234 pounds, Robert Gibson. Their opponent's total combined weight, 524 pounds. First, from Pecos, Texas, Black Bart. His tag team partner from the State Patrol, Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker.
A bad cowboy, a member of the Desperados, and a bad cop.
What do you mean a bad cop?
Got thrown out of the force. He lost his job.
Oh, he did not. He just didn't eat enough donuts, and all the other cops harassed him until he became a professional wrestler.
Fans, we have some interesting comments. I think we should hear it this time from Richard Morton and members of the York Foundation. Let's hear them now.
Now, Robert Gibson, you know who led the Rock and Roll Express to four-time World Tag Team Champion. And I'll prove to you, in front of all the fans on national television, what I dropped on your head. So do not interfere in the York Foundation's business anymore. Or, brother, if the dog's get his day, it will be coming.
I'm really anxiously awaiting the matchup
next Sunday night
involving those two at the Great American Bash. 8 days away as Black Bart forces young Dustin Rhodes back into the ropes. And Bart, another big burly veteran here at WCW, hammers away at the 21-year-old natural. Good counter wrestling move by Dustin. Hip blocks and a big right hand. And Dustin taking care of business with a lot of authority here.
Now, why are you so happy that Richard Morton and Robert Gibson are going to have to slug it out in 8 days?
Because I'm a wrestling fan. I think it's going to be a great wrestling match.
And we're finally going to find out that, after all, it was Richard Morton that was the dominant member of the Rock and Roll Express.
Well, I'm sure that's a debatable point, but the better man will be decided when they meet, and that's what I want to see.
Why don't you come on in here, you yellow-bellied sapsucker?
Uh-oh. He's a yellow-bellied sapsucker.
I ask any gallery seat, Bart. Robert Gibson in.
As they say in your parts, them fighting words.
Come on, Gibson. Come on, Bart. Right hand by Black Bart. Reverse of the Irish whip, and Robert got him up and over. And he's a load. Here comes the sergeant. And Robert Gibson showing tremendous offense, as did his partner, Dustin Rhodes, moments ago. Black Bart can't even find a place to fall. Double elbow, and down goes the big cowboy from Pecos, Texas. He makes the tag with his partner in this contest, Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker. And again, we understand that Mr. Jim Herd has almost concluded his meeting with the WCW board, and they are setting up in the media area here at the Coliseum for his statement. We should be going to that shortly. Nice move. Oh. Inverted atomic drop. And another atomic drop. Dustin looking phenomenal here. That Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker up on top and drop kicks him. Oh, what a move by the kid from Austin. Elbow.
Now, where have I seen that before?
You got the bionic elbow to me. Downstairs. Good double team offense by this team. I'll tell you something, Richard Morton, if he steps in the ring with either of these guys, he's going to have his hands full, because I know that one thing that they, meaning Dustin and Robert, have in common is that neither of them care for the York Foundation. Robert in a near fall situation here.
And that's because neither of them were good enough negotiators to get the right kind of contract from Alexandria York.
They both turned her down. I don't know if Robert turned her down or not. Dustin certainly did.
Well, Richard Morton didn't turn her down, because obviously she felt he was worth enough money that she made him an offer, to paraphrase Marlon Brando.
But he couldn't refuse.
Sergeant Parker now, the right hand, the solar plexus, and one to the jaw of Dustin Rhodes. But Dustin reverses the Irish whip. But the sergeant caught him coming in with a knee and takes him down with a powerful clothesline.
Never Dustin Rhodes' head bounced right off the mat.
Never discount the abilities of Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker. And Big Black Bart comes in. I wonder if he and the rest of Desperados have ever found Stan Hansen. Right hand by Big Black Bart. Fans still to come here on TBS. Terry Taylor will be with us, the Z-Man, PN News, One Man Gang, Rick Steiner's here, Barry Windham Wrestling. It'll be a great broadcast. And Dustin really having his share of problems in his opponent's corner. Oh, he elevated him. Tremendous backdrop. Remember, Dustin's about 6'5", or 6'6". Snap Mare takes him over, and he goes now with nothing but right hand.
Now that's no good. The kid is losing his temper. And it's the one thing that Dustin Rhodes has not done since returning to World Championship Wrestling, is that he's learned how to keep his cool.
There's his bulldog. Great move. Robert Gibson, the legal man. Robert's got him wrapped up. 1, 2, 3, and they win it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, the team of Robert Gibson and the Natural, Dustin Rhodes.
In any shape, form, or fashion, Richard Morton and the balance of the York Foundation must beware of those two.
So here you have it, the Morton haters joining up together. Robert Gibson and the Natural, Dustin Rhodes. Check this out, a drop kick.
Great move.
Oh, no doubt about it. I mean, and it's great double team work by Rhodes and Gibson right here. Here you see it, right in the gut. Here comes Gibson, takes his time, measures his man, but out of nowhere, Dustin comes with the bulldog. Then Gibson comes along, hooks him up, ties him up like a pretzel, and it's a 1-2-3 for the Richard Morton haters.
Fans, we come back. a member of the York Foundation, Terrence Taylor. But first, this.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by the executive director of the York Foundation, Alexandra York, along with the newest member, Richard Morton, and head of security, Mr. Hughes. Ladies and gentlemen, from Vero Beach, Florida, he weighs 236 pounds, the computerized man of the 1990s, Terrence Taylor. His opponent from Miami, Florida, 228 pounds, Johnny Meadows.
Big Mr. Hughes looks on. The gigantic head of security of the York Foundation, and there's the leader, Alexandra York, there, going over last-minute strategy with Terrence Taylor as Richard Morton looks on.
Like I said before, money talks, Gibson walks. Can you imagine how much money it cost Alexandra York to get Richard Morton to sell each and every one of his bands right down the drain?
Lob share was a lot of zeros.
No more visits to Children's Hospital. No more charity work. No more autographs. Here it is, this big hero to all the kids, even to you. You used to love Richard Morton. Oh, what a courageous kid. Oh, a heart of gold. And now he works for the York Foundation.
Well, I can certainly concur that I'm very disappointed in his recent action. I don't blame anyone for trying to make more money, but turning his back on his friends like Robert Gibson and all the great fans, there's no excuse for that, as Terrence Taylor, with a great hip lock takeover, takes over Johnny Meadows. Remember, Terrence Taylor and Stunning Steve will be joining forces 20 feet above the ring, exclusively on pay-per-view July 14th in that scaffold match. And I wonder if they're going to reinforce the scaffold, because in addition to beautiful Bobby being up there with them, Bobby's partner will be the 403-pound TN News. And to the best of my knowledge, no one that size has ever wrestled on a scaffold.
No, never. And I am an expert in the history of scaffold matches, and never has there been a 400-pound grappler 20 feet above the ring.
Fans, I've been informed that they are making ready the media room, getting their cameras set up back there for the statement from Executive Vice President.
Well, what's the statement about?
Jim Herd. Oh, wait, be patient. You know everything that goes on. I don't know. And if I knew, you're the last person I would tell.
Why?
You fat boy. Terrence Taylor having a few choice words with the great fans here in Macon, Georgia, sitting here at ringside. Dollar and elbow tie up again. There's a right hand by Terrence Taylor and another one. Taylor's really dominated this contest thus far. Another elbow there right to the face. Meadows Irish whip to the center of the rope. Well, you got to hand it to him. Terrence is wrestling a very sound match. I don't think you're going to see too many drop kicks 20 feet above the ring on the scaffold, however.
Oh, no, you'd have to be a fool to attempt that in a scaffold match. But he's not wrestling on a scaffold right now. He's making an example out of Johnny Meadows.
Terrence Taylor being harassed by the fans here at the Coliseum. They're not too pleased with the recent action of the York Foundation either. Suplexing Meadows back in is Terrence. Another guy that doesn't sign autographs any longer. Drops the knee right to the face of Johnny Meadows.
And if there was ever a great supporter of Terrence Taylor, It'd have to be the host of this show, Mr. Jim Ross. And here's another one of your friends, another one of the guys that you like, who sold everybody down the drain.
What's your point about it? Is everything referred back to me?
The point is,
blooming idiot,
is that all these people that you had so much trust in, all these people that the fans looked up to, got bought out by the money of Miss Alexandria York. And that's what the 90s are all about.
Well, some people don't have a price. There's got to be loyalty somewhere. Five arm by Terrence Taylor. York Foundation becoming one of the strongest units in WCW.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the computerized man of the 1990s, Terrence Taylor.
Fans, I understand we're only 3 or 4 minutes away from sending it back to Jim Herd.
The five-arm wham on the Johnny Meadows, and another one of your heroes who sold everybody down the drain in the name of money from the York Foundation, Terrence Taylor.
Fans, when we come back, we hope to hear from Jim Herd, and we will see the Z-Man next on TBS.
Set for one fall. Introducing first, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, he weighs 251 pounds, the Z-Man. His opponent from Knoxville, Tennessee, 231 pounds, Joe Cazzana.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the Z-Man and Joe Cazzana here on World Championship Wrestling. And fans, I understand that Mr. Herd is ready for his live statement. We hate to leave this match, but let's go right now to the, here in the Coliseum, to our media room. Let's go to Jim Herd.
Thank you, Jim Ross, and hello, wrestling fans. My name is Jim Herd, and I'm the Executive Vice President of World Championship Wrestling. I'm here to read a very important statement from the World Championship Wrestling Board. World Championship Wrestling is saddened to report that after extensive negotiations with Nature Boy Ric Flair stretching over the course of nearly 1 year, the parties have been unable to arrive at a mutually satisfactory contractual relationship. As a result, the WCW board has decided that the best course of action for WCW and its fans is to declare the World Championship title vacant and to determine a new champion at the Great American Bash, July the 14th in Baltimore. Lex Luger, the number one contender and current United States champion, will remain on the title card at the Great American Bash. His opponent will be determined by the WCW board, and I will be back later in this program with that decision. On a personal note, I want to take this opportunity to extend my best wishes to Ric Flair and wish him the best in the future. He has been a great champion. Back to Jim Ross at ringside.
Fans, that's one of the most flabbergasting announcement I have ever heard. Nature Boy Ric Flair stripped of the WCW World Heavyweight Championship.
I've never heard. I mean, that's never happened before in World Championship Wrestling.
Fans, I've been in the sport 20 years this year. I've been around a lot of big announcements, but I cannot believe that monumental announcement from Executive Vice President Jim Herd, who will be the opponent of Lex Luger at the Great American Bash. As you heard Mr. Herd say, we'll find out that a little bit later in the broadcast. But again, the WCW Championship Committee has stripped Ric Flair of the World Heavyweight Championship. Ric Flair no longer is the WCW champion, and we'll find out who Lex Luger's opponent will be a little bit later here on TBS. But right now, let's go back up to the ring. The Z-Man is in progress with Joe Cazzana. There's a shoulder block by Cazzana. Fans, I want to tell you, I'm going to have a hard time staying focused on this match. I've been around a lot of big announcements, a lot of big matches, but I've never been involved in anything like what has just transpired. We knew that it was a major announcement, but not in our wildest dreams did we ever imagine that the announcement had this much implication throughout the world of WCW wrestling.
I mean, this has only happened in sports once before. when they stripped Muhammad Ali of the undisputed boxing heavyweight championship of the world. I cannot believe that Ric Flair is no longer the heavyweight champion of the world.
Well, I was going to talk, I've got several subjects to talk about tomorrow night on AM 750 WSB. But one of the topics I know you fans are going to want to call in and talk about is this announcement. Ric Flair is no longer the world's heavyweight champion. Lex Luger will still wrestle for the title. And we'll find out who his opponent will be in this broadcast. And those two will wrestle for the world championship. So we will have a new champion at the Great American Bash exclusively on pay-per-view on July 14th. It's going to be Lex Luger or his opponent, quite obviously.
Yeah, but who is his opponent going to be?
Did you hear what Mr. Hurd said, Paul?
Yes, I heard what Mr. Hurd said, Jim.
I don't know who it's going to be.
Well, who do you think?
I have no idea. A lot of great contenders. We saw the top 10 early to broadcast. That's just a partial list of the great stars here at WCW.
This is no trick, right?
You think it's April 1st? Today is July the 6th. 8 days from the Great American Bash. This is no hope.
It's really over. I can't believe it.
Z-Man going for a pin here. And for the fans of Z-Man, fans, we are apologizing for not focusing more on this contest. We know that you fans of the Z-Man are very concerned about his situation with the Diamond Stud. We saw at the very top of this broadcast the humiliating and embarrassing situation the Diamond Stud put the Z-Man in.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the Diamond Stud stripped the Z-Man not just of his clothing, but of his dignity as well.
Joe Kazana in a near fall situation. Well, I'll tell you something. Not only will our great listeners of our radio broadcast tomorrow night on AM 750 WSB have plenty to talk about, but as soon as we get off the air, I'm going to try to have a meeting with Jim Hurd and update the wrestling hotline. So for our fans of the wrestling hotline, we're going to bring you a report on that. If I can meet with Mr. Hurd just for a few minutes after we go off the air here tonight. And he is still going to be back with us in the broadcast to let us know just exactly who Lex Luger will be wrestling. And the winner of that match on July 14th will be the new World Heavyweight Champion. So we can say without a shadow of a doubt, there will be a new WCW champion crowned on July 14th. Z-Man working on the arm of Joe Kazana. Man, I can't believe that.
Oh, this is unprecedented.
As far as I know, it's never happened in WCW. It's never happened in the long, illustrious history of the WCW championship belt. Simply, comeback kick. Good move there by the Z-Man.
And now the Z-Man going up top, and this is the maneuver that once made him the world TV champion.
Kick, and you can hear the impact from that one. Diamond Stud, beware of the Z-Man.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the Z-Man.
Here you see the Z-Man really on a roll since coming back to World Championship Wrestling, coming off the ropes. Beautiful dropkick right in the mush on Joe Kazana. But in the back of his mind, even as he flies off the top rope, he has to be thinking of the man that stripped him not just of his clothing, but of his dignity as well, the Diamond Stud.
Fans, still to come, the big news from Jim Hurd, who will wrestle Lex Luger at the Great American Bash on July 14th. We'll find out that when we come back on TBS.
Contrary to popular belief, you don't have to get in the ring to get your hands on these guys. Introducing the Stomp Collection. Sting, Lex Luger, Ric Flair. All the legends of World Championship Wrestling. Wherever trading cards are sold.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Motown. He weighs 403 pounds. The Repmaster, T.N. News. It's like a freight train running through your brain. For P.N. News, the posse goes insane. The posse's pumping. There ain't no doubt. P.N. News is the winner. Wipe out. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo. I say yo, baby, yo, baby, yo. Yo, word. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Little Rock, Arkansas, 221 pounds, Tim Fry.
All right, fans, welcome back here to TBS. Jim Ross and Paulie Dangerously here at ringside. And if you just joined us, as Tim Fry tries to gain the early advantage on TN News, Jim Herd made an announcement that the WCW Championship Committee and Board of Directors has stripped Ric Flair of the World's Heavyweight Championship. Flair is no longer the WCW World's Heavyweight Champion. Lex Luger will still wrestle for the world title at the Great American Bash pay-per-view on July 14th. And in this broadcast, we will find out who Luger's opponent will be as TN News looks to be rolling into another victory here.
So in other words, Lex Luger could even be fighting a friend of his like the Rap Master TN News.
Certainly could be. That is a possibility. TN News will be the biggest man ever on the scaffold in 8 days. And they better reinforce that thing. He's going to be 20 feet above the ring. TN News, dropkick by the big man. He and Beautiful Bobby to take on Stunning Steve Austin. And, of course, Terrence Taylor.
Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo.
And TN News, as we know, Paul, has had some problems with a guy I know that you're quite friendly with, Johnny B. Badd.
Johnny B. Badd, who's in his hometown this evening. And I understand that Little Richard, who idolizes Johnny B. Badd, is in the back right now trying to get Johnny's autograph.
Well, I'm somewhat dubious of that statement.
You know, Johnny is the only true rap master here in World Championship Wrestling.
Well, we're going to hear some comments from Johnny B. Badd and see him in action as the broadcast progresses here. Big elbow drop. TN News, you already had him standing here when he came out.
You know, Johnny gave me a rap to sing about TN News.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
I'm sure you're just dying to use it. We'll just forget it.
What do you mean, forget it?
Nice arm, nice wrist lock there. Put a lot of pressure on the wrist by TN News.
Oh, man.
Fireman carry takeover.
Can you imagine the impact when a guy 403 and a half pounds does that to you?
I don't even want to imagine it, to be quite honest with you. TN News has been dominant in this contest.
Uh-oh.
Bear hug.
Belly to belly.
He sends him forward and then really drives him home. Reminiscent of our great friend Magnum T.A. in a belly-to-belly suplex. But this is an original 403-pound rap master. He says it's his broken record. Johnny B. Badd. Better beware of that move.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the rap master, TN News.
Well, here you see it, TN News. Now, wait a minute. You keep my
baby, yo, baby, yo. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo. The posse knows things are going my way. They know I'll make it to the top. Day by day. Because I'm living large and I'm staying in charge. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo.
Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo.
I said, yo, baby, yo, baby, yo.
Now, who cut my microphone off in favor of him?
A very wise audio man. Fans, we'll see Johnny B. Badd in action. But first, let's hear these comments from Johnny B. Badd and Theodore R. Long.
That wasn't fair.
next Sunday night, the Great American Bash. I'm going to collect more money, because we're going to take that mask off of you, Yellow Dog, and we're going to let everybody know that it's Brian Pillman. Now, everybody want to know what up with PN News. Well, beautiful Johnny B. Bad, tell them what up with PN News.
Oh, hush, Teddy. What up is my big left hook upside your big old ugly head.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, the godfather of world championship wrestling, Theodore R. Sloan, proudly presents from Macon, Georgia, weighing 251 pounds, Johnny B. Bad. His opponent from Florence, South Carolina, weighing 234 pounds, Chad Floyd.
Johnny B. Bad has interesting comments as usual. There's Theodore Long. Johnny B. Bad. PN News. But pretty unique matches. I've seen a couple of situations where they've had some very interesting hand-to-hand combat.
Well, this is one dangerous competitor. I mean, he knocked out Razor Ruddock, and you know who that is. That's the guy that went the whole distance with Mike Tyson, and they ripped him off and just gave the match to Tyson because they felt sorry for the guy.
I thought you were a Tyson fan.
Not anymore. You know why?
Why?
He's another one that's made it 50 Hyatt.
Oh, man. Johnny B. Bad
would never date Missy Hyatt.
Has a dynamic left hand. He is flamboyant. He is very unique. There is no doubt about that. But we cannot discount his athletic ability. He certainly is blessed with a tremendous amount of athletic ability. And his one-loss record is one that is certainly to be envied by many of the stars here in WCW.
Not just in wrestling, but in boxing as well. This is a two-sport champion, and he will be a champion here in World Championship Wrestling. Hey, this could be the guy that goes against Luger for the title next Sunday.
Fans, we will be, as I understand that Jim Herd is, as we speak again in conference with the WCW Board of Directors and the Championship Committee. They have conference calls set up with many of the board members that could not be here. Many of them are in attendance here in the Coliseum here today. And we will be hearing from Jim Herd again. And he'll let us know just who will wrestle Lex Luger at the Great American Bash.
Whoa!
Very insulting gesture there. He's quick on his feet, I'll tell you.
Oh, he most certainly is. I mean, hey, he has to run away from all those women that are always chasing him down for dates.
Chad Floyd going for a pin as Johnny B. Bad was talking to Teddy, as he calls him.
And I don't think Johnny was too happy about that.
Front face lock. Suplex, great move there. Real good offensive move by Johnny B. Bad. Still to come to broadcast. One Man Gang is here. Rick Steiner is here. An update on Scott Steiner. As Peanut Head Theodore R. Long, who calls himself the Godfather, with some insulting kick to Chad Floyd. I don't think he's going to bruise him or anything, but certainly is humiliating.
Beautiful clothesline by Johnny B. Bad. And notice how everybody here in Macon is so happy to see their hometown hero. Look how many people are saying, "You're number one, Johnny. You're number one."
Fans, don't forget this Monday night, the Great American Bash Tour will stop in Columbus, Georgia at the historic Municipal Auditorium there. 7 o'clock is the starting time. Slam by Johnny B. Bad. Then he comes at you with a flurry. A lot of different high impact moves. He's strong and he's quick.
And he's bad.
And he's a little different, but be that as it may, high knee caught Chad Floyd right in the jaw. Teddy Long must think he's Don King out there, barking boxing instructions.
And here it comes. Wham!
Good. Left hand found its mark, and Johnny B. Bad, in front of the whole crowd, wins it right here.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Johnny B. Bad.
Fans, whether it's in Richmond tomorrow night, Columbus, Georgia Monday night, or Tallahassee, Florida Tuesday night, don't miss the Great American Bash when it comes to your area, and this is really insulting.
Oh, there it is.
You get a good shot of that right there and let you look at it right there. That's what's going to happen right here. Right here, what's going to happen?
The Godfather just told Johnny to give him the kiss of death. Here you see it. Johnny B. Bad in a successful homecoming, taking out Chad Floyd. Hey, this kid never had a chance, but don't worry. He's in there with one of the best. Wham! Right across the face, Johnny B. Bad knocks out yet another opponent.
Fans, we come back. We'll hear from the world's biggest and worst barber right after this. And World Championship Wrestling. Before we see the giant one-man gang in action, let's hear these comments from Kevin Sullivan.
Ha ha ha! Elegante, just like Samson! You lost all your strength when we shaved your head! Well, Elegante, get ready for the bash because it's gonna be a long, hot summer. Yeah. You see, the lady at the third eye came into the one-man gang. And they went into the sweat box, and they stayed there. And when he screeched with delight as the move came up, I knew it was a time to shackle him. And he came out, he said to me, Elegante, there's only one true giant at World Championship Wrestling, and it's him. And if you don't believe it, Elegante, you yourself, you get an appointment with the lady of the third eye, because it doesn't matter if it goes across the country or to South America. We're going to bring your head on a platter and deliver it to her.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest on World Championship Wrestling, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by Kevin Sullivan from Halsted Creek, Chicago, Illinois, weighing 412 pounds. He says he is the true giant of World Championship Wrestling, the One Man Gang. His opponent from Knoxville, Tennessee, 228 pounds, Kenny Hornaday.
Well, it looks like the one-man gang started to give Mr. Hornaday a little of a trim there as he just comes in that dominating style in the ring. 412, his weight goes up and down, but it's always over that 400-pound mark. And one thing about it, I've had a couple of conversations with Elegante.
Mr. Sullivan, when he speaks to you, that's the real giant right there,
okay.
right there, he said.
Well, I had a talk with Elegante, a couple of them, as a matter of fact, and he's not going to take this sitting down, lying down, or any other way.
Who is your translator?
I'm not going to take this lying down.
He speaks much better English than one would perceive. He's really learning. He's really wanting to learn. He loves America. He loves all the Spanish-speaking fans. He's looking forward to going to California. He loves his hair.
Seeing all the people that sneak across the border, stuff like that, right?
We have great Spanish fans and great Spanish Americans.
Well, if he speaks such good English, how come he couldn't say, well, just a little bit off the sides and a little bit off the top? No, he had to tell them, just take it all off. See, if there wasn't such a language barrier, the guy wouldn't know how to ask for a decent haircut.
Well, he didn't ask for the haircut, and you know that as well as anyone else. Attack from behind, then fought with two 747s, one on his ribs, one on his back. Sullivan was there, and Sullivan is a deranged. Sullivan's not a normal manager. He's in great condition. He's strong, and, you know, he's not just a mouthpiece.
Oh, he's a very dangerous individual. I mean, this is one circumstance where you might want to be inside the ring instead of outside the ring with the manager. Because he's the kind of guy that'll stick his thumb through your eye just for fun.
Well, we knew that one-man gang, and led by that man, Kevin Sullivan, had a problem with Elegante. We saw that back at Super Brawl back in St. Petersburg in May. But it will culminate in a one-on-one matchup during the Great American Bash. Two huge men. I don't combine weight of those two. They're around that 900-pound mark when you add both one-man gang and Elegante together.
Well, I think Elegante lost a few pounds because, you know, doesn't have any hair anymore.
Well, he has a little different situation, Paul. He's growing his hair back, something that some of us are having problems doing.
Oh, well, what are you trying to say there?
I'm saying that you're going to end up looking like Danny Hornaday if you're not careful. And the one-man gang, who has been so dominant in this contest, has been instructed to fly with a 747. Man, that is devastating.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, the one-man gang.
I think they're going to do it to him again.
And this is what is so appalling. Absolutely no reason for that to happen. And wait a minute. There comes a barber himself.
Ah, what is that?
He's got some scissors and a straight razor in his hand.
Turn around, Kevin! Turn around!
Oh, the giant hand of Elegante! He's got those scissors! He's cutting some of Sullivan's hair! He got a souvenir, and the hair is flying! He got a big handful of Sullivan's hair!
Suppose that was called for.
Well, he got to play by the same rules that was laid down. Look at his hair growing back. Man, what a situation here, fans. Rick Steiner is next on TBS.
In the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Detroit, Michigan, weighing 265 pounds, co-holder of the WCW World Tag Team Championship, ladies and gentlemen, Rick Steiner. His opponent from Savannah, Georgia, 212 pounds, Brian Jernigan.
Fans, we understand that they are preparing again to have the statement from Jim Herd regarding who will wrestle Lex Luger on July 14th at the Great American Bash. And speaking of, I love Rick and Scott. If you'd like to send a get well card to Scott Steiner, get your pencil and paper handy. We're going to give you an address just a little bit later in this match. Well, you can write Scott your get-well wishes. I know he would appreciate hearing from you. He has not started his rehabilitation as of yet, and it looks as if he will be out of action for 2 or 3 months.
So now Big Brother is going to have to go at it all alone in the cage with his girlfriend, Missy Hyatt, against myself, Barry Windham, and Arn Anderson.
Good belly-to-belly suplex. I don't know. They may have a surprise in store for you for that one. Yes. One thing we can tell you, fans, is that...
Oh, who's going to be their partner now? Jason Hervey?
Rick Steiner is fulfilling all his obligations. Man, what a Steiner line. I'll take a close look at that one.
Why?
Because he's going to be in the cage at the Great American Bash. And that Steiner line looks like it's just tailor-made for you.
Yeah, but, you know,
Fans, I want to tell you that they are going to fulfill, Rick Steiner and a mystery partner will be fulfilling the contractual tag team matches. Now, during the bash, I don't know what the WCW committee is going to do. Obviously, they've been having a major meetings about the World Heavyweight Championship. And I know they're going to address this situation because we're coming very close to 30 days with Scott being out of action and the Steiners not defending the World Tag title.
You don't think he'd actually Steinerline me in the cage, do you?
No doubt about it. He told me, this, as a matter of fact, he wanted me to be sure he dedicated that I told you this move was for you.
No.
Envision Paul Lee up there. And he saves right off the top rope. Rick Steiner. Oh, what a guy. What a man.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Rick Steiner.
Be sure to get get your pencil and paper handy now. We're giving you that address in just a few more moments as we take another look. Describe this, Paul.
Well, you see, he's going to enter the cage, and if he gets me in this, he's going to,
he's going to put you in the hospital. He's going to shut your mouth for good. Vance, be sure to send Scott your get well wishes.
Well, how about me?
The address is coming up, and we'll be giving you an address for Paul about the 15th of July. Remember, Jim Hurd's announcement, I understand. I've just been told coming up very soon, so stay tuned. Back, ladies and gentlemen, to World Championship Wrestling. Jim Ross and Paul Lee Dangerously here at ringside. If you just joined us early in the broadcast, we heard comments from Executive Vice President Jim Hurd. The WCW Board of Directors and Championship Committee has stripped Nature Boy Ric Flair of the World's Heavyweight Championship. We will have a championship match in 8 days at the pay-per-view. It will be Lex Luger, Paul, and an opponent. You have any guess?
I have no idea who this could be, but I know that he's coming out of the WCW top 10.
I understand that Mr. Hurd is standing by. Let's go back to the media room.
Let's go to him.
Thanks, guys. The WCW board has made its decision, and I'm sure you will be as happy as I am to sanction the following bout on the July 14th Great American Bash for the World Heavyweight Championship in Baltimore. The World Heavyweight Championship bout. It's Lex Luger versus Barry Windham. What a bout. What a night. The Great American Bash, July the 14th from Baltimore, Maryland.
What a match.
Barry Windham.
What a match that
Barry
is going
Windham.
To be.
Huh?
Former tag team partners, Barry Windham and Lex Luger will wrestle for the Heavyweight Championship of the World in 8 days on pay-per-view.
Barry Windham and Lex Luger, now here are two guys that really know each other. They have been partners. They fought over the U.S. Heavyweight Championship 2 years ago. Now, in 8 days, they go at it for the Heavyweight Championship of the World.
What a broadcast it has been.
You're
Luger
welcome.
And Windham for the world title in 8 days. Let's go back up to Gary Capet.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by the chairman of the board of the Diamond Exchange, Diamond Dallas Page. He weighs 298 pounds. The Diamond Stud. His opponent, parts unknown, 219 pounds. The Blade. Heel, 6'7", 298 pounds, the Diamond Stud. Now let's get our girl up here. That's right, across the country and around the world, we're looking for a studette, a lovely lady who decks these legs out, mama. All right, baby. Are you ready to handle this hunk of a man? Are you ready? Are you sure? Now reach your hands in there and pull it off.
Doesn't look to me like
don't
she impressed
us, the we'll
stud.
Call you, honey. But she was wonderful. She was marvelous, but see ya.
Well, I think it's totally appalling trying to solicit these young ladies to become a studette, auditioning like this. Very humiliating for young ladies like
it
that.
It certainly is appalling to have an ugly chick like that applying well, for a job.
What a situation. Barry Windham, Lex Luger will wrestle in the cage at the Great American Bash at pay-per-view. One of those two men will be the new World Heavyweight Champion. And as luck would have it, Barry Windham was scheduled to wrestle here today. He will still wrestle here, and if we have time, I've got to talk to him about this situation that's going to occur on pay-per-view in 8 days.
So in other words, one way or another, 8 days from now, we will see the crowning of a brand new undisputed heavyweight champion of the world at the Great American Bash.
That's what I figured, Mickey Flayne.
Oh, well, now I'm writing mystery novels, huh?
Diamond Stud, no mystery about this guy. 6'7", 298.
I think the Blazers can is on fire right now.
And this Diamond Stud, as we mentioned, we're looking forward to his one-on-one match with the Z-Man. Two great young athletes here in WCW, but this guy, 6'7", 298 pounds, great agility for a big super heavyweight. Alpha right now.
And everything he does so smoothly. I mean, this is one brutal, brutal competitor. And the Z-Man has already learned what the Diamond Stud is all about.
Fans, it's been a very dynamic and shocking program here thus far on TBS. And I expect nonetheless tomorrow night in Richmond or Monday in Columbus, Georgia, or perhaps even Tuesday in Tallahassee. And the Blaze rammed ribs first into the steel security railing.
And notice how Diamond Dallas Page doesn't even touch the man. He doesn't have to, because each and every one of his words are backed up by the 6'7", 298-pound Diamond Stud.
He sets him for the Diamond Death Drop. Diamond Stud has the mask blazed and brings him down with so much velocity. Diamond Stud hooks the leg. Is waiting on the Z-Man.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the Diamond Stud.
I've got to get with Jim Hurd and update the wrestling hotline about this Luger Wyndham situation.
Now, whether it be this Tuesday in Tallahassee, Florida, Columbus, Georgia, this Monday, the Diamond Stud with a big announcement concerning the Z-Man. He's going to be bringing in his Diamond Depth Drop to town.
A man that could be the next World Heavyweight Champion, Barry Windham, is next on TBS.
On TBS, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Sweetwater, Texas, he weighs 278 pounds, Barry Windham. His opponent from Los Angeles, California, 238 pounds, Jackie Fulton.
Fans, we must remind you there'll be no main event tomorrow night, but we will be talking about this entire situation tomorrow night at 9 o'clock for 1 hour on AM 750 WSB, and we'll take your calls there. Barry Windham and Lex Luger will wrestle to see who will be the next WCW World Heavyweight Champion on pay-per-view. That will occur on Sunday, July the 14th. Paul, I understand you'll be talking to Lex Luger right here next Saturday night.
That's right. I most certainly will, in a special edition of the Danger Zone next Saturday night right here on TBS, the total package, Lex Luger.
Jackie Fulton is an outstanding young competitor. Younger brother of Bobby Fulton, of the fantastic, but Barry Windham. So much has been predicted for this young athlete since he first debuted in the sport. He is a second-generation wrestler. And with Lex Luger, he once held the World Heavyweight Tag Team Championship. He has been a United States Heavyweight Champion, as is Luger at this current time.
That's right, and it's Luger and Windham who traded the U.S. title back and forth in 1989. And now Windham has a chance. There it is.
Fulton's leg in the rope there, stops the count. Also, I want to remind you fans, next Saturday night, in addition to that Danger Zone, there'll be a Bounty six-man tag team event featuring the Yellow Dog, Beautiful Bobby, and Ron Simmons on one team. Next Saturday night, they'll be facing Arn Anderson, Larry Zbyszko, and the TV champ, Stunning Steve Austin. So next Saturday night, a very big broadcast at 6.05 Eastern, 5.05 Central, here on TBS.
Tremendous DDT by Barry Windham, who in 8 days gets the chance of a lifetime. He goes for the heavyweight championship of the world against the total package, Lex Luger.
Windham has, on more than one occasion, been very close to being the world's heavyweight champion. But by being the number two contender in the WCW top 10 rankings, of course, Lex Luger is number one. He earned the right by his one-loss record. And that number two position, you got to think the guys Sting and Nikita Koloff are just a notch or two away from getting that opportunity as well.
And here's the thing. Inside the cage, Luger has been training for Flair. He doesn't fight Flair now. He fights Wyndham. Wyndham was training for the match with the Steiners. He doesn't fight the Steiners. Now he's going to fight Luger. Each man cannot say, neither one can say, I'm ready for this match. They both go in with only 8 days of preparation to see who will be the heavyweight champion of the world.
With 8 days preparation, Luger may be at a disadvantage because Wyndham has the edge in experience. And this move right here, can you imagine Luger in this position? The superplex. He floats over. Will he be the new world champion? We'll find out in 8 days.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Barry Wyndham.
We'll try to get a word with Barry Wyndham, Paul, as we take another look.
We are just 8 days away, next Sunday, July 14th, exclusively on pay-per-view, the Great American Bash, Barry Wyndham, Lex Luger, locked in a cage, and only one man will emerge as the heavyweight champion of the world. Will it be Barry Wyndham? He's standing by right now at ringside with Jim Ross.
Fans, it has certainly been a dynamic hour here on TBS. As you heard, the WCW Championship Committee has stripped Ric Flair of the world title. In 8 days, it will be Barry Wyndham and Lex Luger in a cage on pay-per-view. The winner will be the new world heavyweight champion.
You know what? I'm going to tell you the difference between me and Lex Luger. The United States heavyweight champion is always the number one contender. He may not defend his championship every night, but I'm the guy that's got to work hard. I'm number two. I'm the contender that's got to prove myself every night. And there's not a doubt in anybody's mind who the next heavyweight championship holder is. I am after the World Heavyweight Championship, and I'm not going to let Lex Luger stand in my way. I walked behind Ric Flair for 4 long years and made sure that he kept that championship belt. My turn is up. And I'm going to walk the aisle like the nature boy never could.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Well, Barry, I want to tell you, these fans right here, I think, are solidly behind Lex Luger, it would seem.
Listen, if you'll open your ears a little bit, instead of being as biased as you always are, they're right here. These people know that I'm the world's heavyweight champion, and I can take the belt at any given time. So if you don't like it, lump it.
Fans, it will be determined inside a steel cage, exclusively on pay-per-view in 8 days. For Gary Michael Capetta and Paul E. Dangerously, I'm Jim Ross. So long, everybody.
The greatest wrestling in the world is World Championship Wrestling. And now you can support your favorite World Championship Wrestling superstar with exciting gifts and souvenirs from WCW Merchandise. To receive your free World Championship Wrestling